am Srinivas from IT department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss about harmful acts in cyber security. We'll discuss about harmful acts. Generally, there are different types of harmful acts. What is a harmful act? Nothing but it is unlawful activities that has been done by cyber crime people, right? Right. Here we have different types of categories classified into four types. The first one is cyber crime against a person. Second one is cyber crime against a property. Cyber crime against a government. Cyber crime against a society. So these are the things comes under cyber crimes. And generally, what is a cyber crime? It can be defined as the unlawful acts where the computer is used either as a tool or a target or either it may be a both, right? So first of all, we'll see what is a cyber crime against a person, right? Again, it is classified in different types. The first one is it is classified into different types. The first one is in that person. First one we call it as cyber stalking, right? The first one is cyber stalking. The cyber stalking is the word means nothing but unwanted or obsessive attention, right? Here, this is one of the unwanted things that can be created by a person or individual or a group of people, right? Here it is created and sent through different types of medium, right? It may be a threat created by and sent to the different types of medium, such as we can call it as internet, email or SMS, webcams, photos, phone calls, everything, right? So this is the one of the threat created by a group of people or one of the people or individuals, right? After that, they can be sent to different types of medium. Either it may be email or it may be SMS, webcams or phones, right? This is the first one. Second one is cybercrime hacking. So what is cybercrime hacking? Hacking is nothing but you can say that unauthorized access can be done by other people, right? Unauthorized access can be done. So generally in the internet they can be people without authorization, they can be access everything, right? These people can be they can destroy the data which are all data stored in the computer system, right? So this is called as cyber hacking. The third one is you can call as cracking. Here cracking is nothing but different types of, like we have a Windows 10 or different types of movies will be there. The term refers to digitally removing the copyright of the protection code, right? So we can remove the copyright of the protection code using this cracking. Here it can be done by using a software or it may be different types of tools they can use to remove that particular digital copy, right? This is a cracking. And the next one is defamation. So what is the term refers to defamation is called as damaging the reputation of a person or it may be an organization or it may be anything. So these people are damaging some reputation. It may be affect to the public or private sectors. So damaging reputation nothing but damaging everything using a threat or anything, right? So this is called as defamation, right? Generally example for this one is posting a vulgar messages in the websites and also photos or different types of things that can be spread to the entire system, right? This is a defamation. And the next one is online fraud. So nowadays it has been increased very lot using online fraud, doing different types of frauds, taking money from the different types of persons, right? So online fraud. So this is the thing what these persons are able to steal everything from our data, like maybe credit card details or it may be our banking details or it may be any different types of personal information, financial information that can be stayed by the people, right? So we have we can call it as banking credentials or we can have different types of SMS or using different types of things, right? So then the next one is spoofing. Spoofing is nothing but the term means that imitating something. a person is calling to other person, is a communication between two persons. The person acting like a bank employee and is acting like a bank employee, other person acting like a different manager, right? Both persons play a game and they can able to take all the information from that particular customer, right? They can call everything and they can easily take that particular things or financial details from that customer, and it can, the data can be handled by the customer. So different types of things can be done in the scoping, right? So here what happens, the identity is nothing but they can show the identity of a bank employee, right? They can show the identity of bank employees, they indicate like a different person, like a bank employee, bank manager. So there you can call it as scoping, right? The next one is what we are talking about, the cybercrime against the property. Cybercrime against the property is nothing but different types of things classified in this one, property. The first one is called as transmitting a virus. So this is a virus that can be able to spread to different types of systems, right? So it is a malware, or we can say that it is a malware, or it may be a ransomware, or it may be a spyware, or it may be a virus, right? Different types of malware that can be able to spread through a system, through a media, right? So here what happens the second one is, right? So sending a different types of virus to the other systems, right? Transmitting a virus into the other system using through the system, email or messages, everything, right? The second one is cyber squatting. Cyber squatting nothing but occupying the other space. Suppose a Facebook profile has been created a person. So the two profiles has been created in the single person only. So occupying different identity of other person, right? We have a two domains, but actually it is a one domain, occupying two domains, like the Facebook profiles, right? Here, unlawfully occupying the uninhabited place for cyber squatting. So we have a two or more persons, but they came that we have a only domain name is same, such as Facebook profiles, or it may be any other Twitter apps, anything, right? This is a cyber squatting. The third one is cyber vandalism. So cyber vandalism is nothing but refers to involving deliberate destruction or damage of public. Here what these people are doing, completely doing a destruction of or damage to other persons, like it may be private or public, any type of damaging to the particular society, right? Private or public. And the next one is intellectual properties. Here we have different types of intellectual property crimes. The first one is TM, nothing but a trademark, and we can say that a patent, or it may be other one is like IPR, intellectual property, right? Here these people can able to remove these things using the crimes also. They can be done by using the different methods, right? And the next one is cyber crime against the government. Cybercrime against the government. In this we have different types again. Cyber warfare. Nowadays it has been very much increased in the cyber crimes in the world wide web due to lockdown, right? So cyber warfare is one of the internet based conflict that involves politically motivated attacks. So these people are wantedly, they are doing a cyber warfare on internet based connection systems, such as internet connection, and also they can steal or alter different types of data using a person or individual person, and using a Sensex, or it may be details on any official websites, like it may be different types of online shopping or anything, right? So like a Flipkart or Amazon, they want to do something warfare on particular politically motivated particular websites. And the next one is cyber terrorism. Cyber terrorism is one of the it is also one of the cyber crime, but they can create a fear among the people. It may be attack on people or organization or any government in government sectors or private sectors. They can create a fear on the particular system. It may be government or private. They want to, right. The next one is cyber crime against the society. So cybercrime against society, nothing but they want to steal the money. Generally nowadays it is one of the online fraud, like online gambling is going on very much, So these people, like generally example is for Nigerian people, has been doing very much because they are playing game on particular one. They want to take the money from the particular people, right? So here, online plumbing is nothing but one of the most lucrative businesses nowadays. So using internet, they can able to take the money from the customers or individuals or any other persons. So sending a mails or emails or messages or anything to the calling people, customers, and you got a lottery and $1,000, $2,000, like that, they are sending emails, messages. So we don't attract the particular emails, messages, and we need to have an alert on these different types of messages. And they can operate and work. They can operate in sitting in the different location. They can operate at different level. Those are the persons they have a so network. Around 50 to 100 people are calling in different language and different type. Right? This is called as online gambling. And the next one is cyber trafficking. This is one of the trafficking means dealing involving different types of activities that has been done on illegal activities that has been done on cyber crimes. And generally calling a persons like kidnapping everything or kidnapping in the WhatsApp or different types of messages or calling to other persons, they can use this cyber trafficking. And the next one is internet governance challenges and constraints. Right? In this internet governance, we have different types of applications and principles and norms and also rules, decision making procedures. We have set of rules to follow this internet governance. And also we have a we have a programs and shapes how to use this internet governance properties and set of methods in this one. And the next one is, this one of the article describes that internet was currently governed, and some of the controversies occurred along the way, right? So this is one of the things that can be done by this internet governance challenge. We have different types of challenges and constraints, and this is one of the countries with the e-governance. We have different types of technologies are carrying out this using the government duties. And the next one is, we have these people having some policy makers and also objectives, or they have a set of like ends and means, right? Different types of strategies they are having to identify these strategic objectives. And also they are having some resources available to the reach those objectives, and that they have means, and also provide different types of ways. Such resources are to be applied, and we have different types of objectives, right? And we have a right. So we have different types of cyber. We can say that we have harmful acts, different types of layers in the cyber security. We have different types of rules and policies, set of methods, what we are using in our day-to-day life. And we have different types of threats, what that has been occurred to daily life, to the person, or maybe a group of individuals, or it may be a different types of people that has occurred by the people. And cyber crimes nowadays, it has been very much rapidly increasing due to lockdown in the previous last year. And we have different types of cases that has been given on the papers also, right? Due to cyber crimes, like calling the phones, using emails, and they are taking advantage of people. Those are having less economy nowadays, right? And we have seen there is a lot of articles which has been read in the last year and now up to nowadays. And we have mostly these people are doing Nigerian people has been doing these people like playing games with other persons, like calling to the persons and also calling to the we have these people having some network. The network is around 100 and sitting somewhere and remotely. They are operating on different types of phones and different types of languages. And also they can be able to use different types of tools to hack the particular websites, right? And the personal details also, right? And also, thank you.